All right, how you guys doing? Solder Knuckles with Slow Pro. We are out here putting a copper roof on a steeple for this church. And we're actually doing it in diamond shingles that we have handmade. So it starts out with a template. We get all these individual pieces cut to the length that we want. And then we're just gonna basically bend those around. So I'll show you what to do for that. So get a mark right there. Snip this in about an inch and a quarter. Now, you take this hemming tool, and we're going to hem these edges around 1 inch. It just fits right in there, and you can see it gives you a perfect inch every time. Then the top two over around the fascia. So you're looking at those two hems. On the bottom one, you actually hem it around the opposite way. Fit it in there. Okay. So there it is. That's the shingle. So once we get these all made together, I'm just taking about 34, 35 of them aside. So once we get all of these hemmed, we'll take you up in the lift and show you how we put it on.
All right, guys, so the next step for the roof system is going to be putting our drip edge on. We've got our ice and water shield here for protecting for any moisture that gets behind this metal. You put this up here so that way the next shingles can lock in to where it's all hemmed together. Start in the middle, always. You work your way out to the outside. Bend these corners around. There you go. Next step completed.
So, my brother Aaron just showed you guys how to put the drip edge on, and like you said, you know, our first starter course is actually going to hem to the bottom of this drip edge to give you good wind uplift resistance. We've got our ice and water shield behind this product. It's a step that a lot of guys are going to skip when they do their drip edge. You're going to put their drip edge right to this bare wood. You know, the problem with that is as this copper sweats over time, you know, it is making contact with this CDX plywood and is going to break that product down over time. So the type of ice and water shield that we're using, the type of moisture barrier, the underlayment, is a heat tolerant or heat stable ice and water shield. So it's this product right here. We're going to put this down over the deck. It has an adhesive back on it. So essentially when you roll it out, you can see it sticks down to the roof deck. And then after it's up here for a couple of days and the sun has heated it up, it's going to glue itself right down. So even as we're fastening these copper shingles to this roof, the shaft of the nail going through this product is actually sealing around that nail. So as you get condensation on the back side of this copper, from temperature exchange and stuff like that, you're gonna get some of that condensation. It's never actually soaking into this roof deck. So just, you know, when you're doing a roof like this that's gonna last 100+ years, you definitely wanna make sure that, you know, you're doing the entire system to take that lifespan.
All right, guys, so we're up here gonna make a starter. Basically, we took one of the shingles, cut it in half, left an inch, so that way we can give our hem. We're gonna have these ears that you gotta cut off here. Cut those right off, no problem. You grab your hem tool here, get it in there, like so. Fold it over just like that. Then it makes you a starter just like that. Come over here, and it hooks right in. Take your line, you got a line, so that way you can get it lined up. A lot of people don't do that. Boom. We're gonna go.
All right, so it's time for our second course. As you can see, we've got our starter course on here, hemmed to the bottom of this drip edge for wind uplift. It's good and tight in there. So you can see how we have this top hem on the top edge of these shingles, and then on the bottom edge also a hem. So of course, I mean, it's just going to interlock into itself. So as you come up there, feed it in, and so you can see how these two points are meeting here, and keeping straight with that straight line. So with all of these shingles being handmade, there is going to be some variance, and you know, we actually like it that way. I mean, we install different types of metal roofs, and a lot of your metal roofing is 100% square. So with this being handmade, you're going to have a little bit of variance in between each shingle. So, you know, when you're installing to something that is not 100% square like this church steeple is, it's going to actually add a little bit of randomness to it, and it's actually a much better look than a fully square roof system. So stay tuned. We're going to get a few of these courses up, and then we'll kind of see, you can start to see what the overall product is going to look like.